welcome back to my channel. My name is Brooke. I'm a certified nutrition consultant for postpartum and baby nutrition, and just kind of sharing my journey in motherhood and my passion for helping moms and babies. So today's episode is going to be how I prepared for an unmedicated birth. I had my son back in February of 2021. I had an unmedicated birth at a birth center, and now I'm going to share my 7 tips for how to prepare for an unmedicated birth before actually going into labor. If I tell anybody that they're gonna have an unmedicated birth, there's actually a lot of prep work that I think you have to do beforehand, especially mentally going into it. I know a few people that have had an unexpected unmedicated birth, like they got to the hospital too late, couldn't have an epidural, and had to deliver unmedicated. And it's really, really challenging when you are not expecting that. I pretty much knew right after I got pregnant that I wanted to have an unmedicated birth, ideally at a birth center, and that's what we were able to do. I went into labor and birth with a rough idea of like how I thought it was going to go. I didn't necessarily have expectations of like, okay, I only want to be in labor for this long or this. I was open in that regard, but I was pretty strict in how I wanted it to be unmedicated. I wanted it to be relaxed, calm, and I feel like my birth was exactly how I envisioned. I'm kind of hesitant to say, because I know a lot of people haven't had that experience. I would go through birth 1,000 times over than the like first 2 months postpartum, because that was so much more challenging for me than actual birth, which is wild to say. But anyways, getting to the tips to how to prepare for labor. The research that I started, I realized that it's a mental game from like the very start. Yes, there are certain things that you can help to prepare your body, and I'll share those as well, but you ask most people and they say it's all mental. I fully had to believe, and I still obviously believe this, that my body was capable of delivering my baby without any interventions. No interventions. And I believe that to my core. And I think that's one of the reasons I was able to have success in labor, because your mental state does have a large role in your physical body and like that manifestation. So the first tip is knowing your why. You have to know why you want to have an unmedicated birth. You can't just be like, oh, because I don't think it'd be cool, because, you know, in the thick of it, you're gonna say, I don't want it. You know, you have to know your why and share that with your birth team. So for me, that was sharing it with my husband, sharing it with our doula, were the two main people, and that they understood why I wanted to do that, so that they could remind me when we were in the thick of it. The main thing for me is I wanted to experience birth. I know that's kind of an unpopular opinion, but I wanted to be able to feel my body, work with my body, and deliver my baby as God intended birth to be. I didn't want either one of us to be on medications or anything like that coming into the world in his first birth experience. I didn't want it to be medicated. That was kind of the main reason I wanted to experience birth, and I wanted almost for him to come into the world as wholesome as possible. That was my leading backbone as to why I wanted to deliver unmedicated. You might have heard the term cascade of interventions, and essentially it's once you receive one thing, whether that's an IV drip, Pitocin, whatever, you're more likely to receive other interventions. And for me, it was important to not start anything, so that way it would lead me closer to my end goal of delivering unmedicated. I listened to affirmations daily. I found a few ones that I really liked, and a lot of them, they would say it and it would be a little bit of pause, and I would repeat it back either in my head or verbally even, and that just helped get me into the right mindset. I had to walk our dog morning and night, and so that's when I would listen to them a lot. And then when I was falling asleep, that all gave me good practice to get those in. I also got the birth affirmation cards from Natural Mama. I liked her book. I think her approach and how she delivers information is kind of a great entryway if you're looking to dabble in more of a natural approach. I think she makes it really approachable and easy to understand. I just taped up our birth affirmation cards all around our apartment so I could see them kind of anytime. It was like when I was using the bathroom, when I was in the shower, when I was opening the fridge, when I was touching doors, any kind of high point areas that I was like looking at, I put cards there. And I think it also helped Andy see where my mindset was going to be, because he also saw the cards all around our apartment too. And then I just prayed a lot. I prayed that God would allow my body to grow and stretch and provide everything needed for my baby. I prayed for a safe delivery. I prayed that he would protect my mental space and not let any negative thought creep into my mind or any fears. If there was any times where I was like, oh my God, like, what if this happens, I would stop immediately and I just pray to God and say, God, I know you have designed birth and pregnancy to be exactly what it's supposed to be, and I know my body's capable of this, and I just ask that you please watch over me and protect my mind and my body and my baby so that we can deliver exactly as you intended. And that's what I did a lot. I think it really makes a difference in your mental space. So I think physical exercise is really important, and I don't mean like hitting the gym and working out, just daily movement, I guess it would be a more accurate. But we had a dog, we lived in the second story apartment, so I was constantly climbing stairs and then walking my dog at least 2 to 3 times a day. And I think that helped so much because I was on my feet and allowing gravity to kind of always work itself down and just keep moving, I think is really important for just anything in life. But birth can be so physical, and so I think keeping your body moving and being able to build that stamina up in a sense is really important. I did a lot of walking, and then I did a lot of stretching as well. I love stretching, so I would do some yoga classes, but watch some YouTube videos of stretching and things like that. That was what I mainly stuck with. I didn't really do a ton of actual pregnancy workouts because it just didn't feel right to me. It didn't feel good. I didn't enjoy it. I didn't want to do it. Going to the gym was like, no thank you. I do think, after hearing a few people, that there is a such thing as being too fit, like your pelvic floor is too tight to like be able to relax and allow baby to come down. If you are somebody that's like super active and fit, definitely I would seek out a pelvic floor therapist so you can have them check you and see if you need to maybe tone down exercises, do different exercises to either help strengthen or loosen your pelvic floor, be able to have an easier labor. I also think how you sit is very important. If you're always reclined back, like if you're like laying down a lot on the couch, baby's always gonna be kind of pressed against your back. If I was sitting, I always try to sit crisscross applesauce, or I would be on my hands and knees a lot, or I would like lean forward more, especially in the end, towards like third trimester, I really tried not to like lean back. Also, it kind of wasn't super comfortable for me. I was more comfortable sitting like in a crisscross, like leaned forward position. So that's my advice. I always tell people that as well, because the goal, I think, of third trimester is just getting baby in position. And when you're engaging and leaning forward, it's helping to bring baby down versus plopping them against your spine, which is also not comfortable. For me, as I was preparing for what I knew I wanted, as it was an unmedicated birth, I knew I needed to surround myself and really fill my mind with positive birth experiences. So I had Ina May's book, which I highly recommend. She had so many stories in there, especially if you don't come from an environment or don't have many friends that have gone through an unmedicated birth, that you can't lean on them for their story and their experience. That's an excellent way to hear other stories. Most of the people I know have had medicated, you know, kind of the quote unquote traditional hospital birth. So they, everyone thought I was totally nuts to have an unmedicated birth. I think they knew I could do it, but you could also see the doubt on people's faces, like, oh, okay, we'll see once those contractions kick in. And for me, that almost fueled me even more to prove to them, like, I knew I could do it, but I also wanted to prove to them, like, hey, I know you doubted me, but like, look, I freaking did it. And that's what I told my husband after Ace was born. I freaking did it. Like, I was so proud of myself that I did it, because I know there was a lot of people that were like, okay, we'll see. And I was like, I did it. Thank you very much. If I knew somebody was going to tell me a really bad story, I would kindly tell them, hey, like, I'm only interested in hearing positive birth experiences right now. I understand you had a difficult time and I want to honor that, but is there something positive that you can share with me from your birth, just to help reinforce that positivity? Or if somebody did share their story, I would just, in my mind, I would just reinforce, my body's made to do this. I can do this. God has designed my body to do this. I will deliver my baby safely. Birth is not a medical event. We have medicalized birth, which I think is just a crime in and of itself. It's wild. It's wild. We're not gonna get into that. So that's what I would do if somebody kind of shared a story, is just really reinforce in my mind, my body's made to do this. I can do this. And just keep telling myself that. I heard about chiropractors in pregnancy and the benefits of that shortly before I got pregnant. So as soon as I got pregnant, that was something that was like very, very high on my priority list. I ended up seeking out, and they were just about to open, so it was really perfect timing, was Culture Chiropractic in Queen Creek, Dr. Stephanie and Dr. Ross, and they are just legends. So they were right up the road from us, and we would go 2 to 3 times a week, which is may seem like a lot to a lot of people, and it's certainly an investment, but I think I attribute my easy pregnancy and like how comfortable I was throughout pregnancy with that, because they were constantly just checking my spine, making sure everything was in alignment, making sure nothing was out of whack, and I think really helped just align my body perfectly to also allow baby to come into the world. It was funny, Ace was actually born like 2 weeks early, I think. We were going to the chiropractor on Mondays, and Ace was born on Sunday, and so we ended up going up there and surprising them, and we didn't tell them that we had him, and we just like walked in, and my belly was gone, and we had a baby, and they were like, oh my gosh, and it was just so exciting. It was so cool to surprise them. We love them over there. So I think this is essential and why most people actually end up getting epidurals is because they can't relax their body. That's what an epidural does in a sense, is you're so tense from your contractions and you can't relax your body. So the epidural takes away that pain and allows you to relax your body to be able to let baby come down the birth canal. For me, I started paying attention to when I'm stressed out or tense, where does that show up for me? And for me, it definitely shows up in like my jaw, like I clench a lot, or like my fists or like my shoulders, like that's kind of where I stay. And so I would just kind of try to be mindful of if I noticed I was like tense, relax my jaw. I would always keep my hands open. So like when I was going to sleep, I would used to sleep like this, you know, like on my side with like my hands and fists, and I actually would sleep with them open, just getting used to having them open and relaxed. And jaw tightness also correlates to like hip tightness, being able to relax that, relax your hips, relax your hands, relax your shoulders. Let's have see how many times I can say relax. That's what I would do, is just release the tension in my body and focus on deep breaths. That's one thing I practice a lot with breathing. Just breathing and relaxing so baby could make its way down. We hired Alyssa from Cherry Blossom Doula, and she was just magnificent. She was the exact energy that I needed. I wanted somebody that was calm and relaxed and encouraging and uplifting without being like, you can do it, come on. Like, I didn't need a hype person. I needed low, slow, like gentle guidance, and she was that. She jumped right in. Obviously, she usually comes in the thick of it, and I was indeed in the thick of it, and she just jumped right in and like made me feel comfortable and was doing like pressure and just helped guide us. And she also really helped us to know when to go to the birth center, and she was lovely. Our team was lovely. You could ask her all kinds of questions. She was always there for you, checking in, and I would recommend her to everybody. She has a huge team, and we actually hired a postpartum doula from her company as well, who's also fabulous. I can't say enough great things about them. I hope you found all these tips helpful. I am gonna link some more things in the description, like my Spotify playlist, a podcast, some books, workouts, stretching, our doula, chiropractor, birth course I took. All of that's going to be in the description. Please stay tuned for part 2, which is tips that you can do during labor to have an unmedicated birth. Thanks.